Meryl from Dipbot here, and welcome to our fourth Knowledge Graph Fundamentals video. In this video, we're going to talk about how our Knowledge Graph supports data provenance. Specifically, we'll look at what data provenance is, how data provenance is used, and how provenance is supported in the world's largest knowledge graph. First off, what is data provenance? Succinctly, it's a record of where data is sourced from and how it's been changed, as well as details supporting the confidence in or validity of the data. On the screen now are some adapted dimensions of provenance that are detailed by the World Wide Web Consortium. I'm paraphrasing here, but three categories in which provenance is thought about include the content of provenance information, the management of provenance data, and how provenance is used. In the first category, related to the content of provenance, we can define provenance in terms of what the actual provenance object is, what it's about, what sources or entities can be used to create a new attribution for provenance, what's the process by which provenance is tracked, how does versioning work for provenance objects, can we capture why and how a particular decision is made based on provenance, and is the process by which automated systems serve up answers explainable and checkable? In the second category, related to management of provenance, we have a different set of dimensions. Here, organizations worry about the publication of provenance. How much do you share? Do you share it publicly? How do you explain provenance fields? Through which systems do users query provenance? Additionally, what should access controls, licensing, and dealing with privacy look like? Finally, what are the logistical solutions for serving up large amounts of provenance information? In our third section, we look at how provenance is used. Can you understand how your provenance is consumed by end users? Is your provenance interoperable with data from multiple systems? Can you easily compare provenance of two distinct entities? What's the quality and level of trust in your provenance information? And do you have systems for detecting imperfections in provenance and debugging? Next, what is provenance used for? Simply put, provenance greatly simplifies the process of looking into root causes of data analytics issues. It also enables you to specify how sure you want to be of your data points in a given analysis. Additionally, provenance is important for data quality, reporting, and the reproducibility of results. Now that we've walked through some of the implications of data provenance, let's take a look at how provenance is supported in Dipbot's Knowledge Graph. On the screen, we're looking at the organizational entity from the Microsoft Corporation. There are a range of fact types for organizations, and many are in the visual page, but to really dig into provenance data, we'll need to look at the underlying data. You can do this by clicking on JSON and loading the underlying data or the extended underlying data. I've pasted the results into a JSON viewer, so the format is a bit more human-friendly. So what fields are we interested in? First off, for each one of these value types, note that an explicit origin field is present. This is one or more locations in the public web where a fact was sourced by our AI. Additionally, some origins may have been made by inference, i.e. AI reasoning. Whether explicit origins are based on a location on the web or an inference built from other facts, a confidence score is present. Confidence scores are computed by taking into account the confidence level in the extraction or inference of the fact, as well as how trustworthy the origin site is. Finally, for each origin of each fact, you can find additional details in the Origin Details field. These include when the source was crawled at, so when truly mining in to determine the provenance of a fact, you can determine if you've surfaced external data from an outdated or up-to-date source. While some fields tend to remain immutable, for example, the founding date of a company, others are attached to entity types that change depending on when they're accessed. We're now looking at JSON for an article entity. The last crawl time value provides an epoch time number, which can be converted to a human readable time, for when this article was last crawled, allowing you to compare versions of articles you're accessing if they seem to change. Additionally, the date string value provides a value for when the article was originally published or updated. Note that origins for structured data fields are also present in our extraction and natural language API products, so you can convert unstructured data from many sources into structured data with solid provenance. Thanks for tuning in for our latest Knowledge Graph Fundamentals video. Be sure to check back for more advanced Knowledge Graph related topics in the future.